Alright guys, we're back. We're still on this plane. It has just crashed. It may still be flying. I'm not 100% sure. Oh, hey Amanda, what's up? Oh, you can still buy stuff from her. Okay. Well, that's awesome. I need some serious stamina help. I've got 20 and I need 100. So, like, what's... Yeah, baked beans. Hook me up with some baked beans. To generate our stamina pretty good. We've got plenty of vision. We're about halfway down on life. I'm not 100% sure how the life thing works in this game. Because I was just kind of getting hit during the action sequences, even though I was passing the moves. So I think some of it, you kind of need to keep your life up just because some of it could very well end with you being in trouble. I'm gonna buy a water for my vision. Hey, come on. Increase my life totals. Here we go. Down by... Yeah, we'll just buy a first aid kit. It's a lot of money, but it'll be fine. Here we go. There we go. We're all maxed out. Alright, let's get back to work. Okay, well that's fine. I guess nobody's really mad about me moving luggage at this point. I could have just got free water though. There's some baked beans that I could have used to get so much stamina, but that's fine. You live and learn, and then you get loves. Hey. Deborah, you're not doing good, are you?
I can't take it anymore. My hands and feet are cramping up.
What are you doing that for?
You there. Perfect timing. I can't take it anymore.
Take what?
What is Deborah talking about?
That lightning strike electrified the floor and handrails. So I'm doing my best not to touch them. But I can't take it anymore. My arms, legs, neck, back, everything is screaming in pain.
Well, what do you want me to do?
I need to try and calm it down.
It's not electrified. It's safe. This game is weird.
Lightning striking an airplane. Crazy, huh?
To be fair.
Do you think this plane is okay?
First, squeaking windows, and now seats and floors are electrified? I'm almost impressed by your capacity to worry about the mundane.
Hold it! What was that about the windows?
They were squeaking, right?
Squeaking! The windows! You're saying the windows on this bucket squeak?
Does she not remember anything? Or are we in a different time?
What?
Let me see your notebook. Let me see your notebook. People sniffled light 18 times? She is keeping really close records of something.
My leg. If the windows were really squeaking, why, we'd all be dead by now. That lightning strike would have come in through the cracked window. We'd have smashed into the sea, its surface harder than concrete. It's like Dr. Johnson always says, fall from an airplane and you'll die. So just keep your fear-mongering to yourself.
There certainly doesn't seem to be any counting in her notes. What's going on here then?
Not this squeaking, anyway. So, like, we're in a different, like, time period or a different something.
You also take notes on suspicious people, right?
That's right. There's you, of course. And I've got notes on that guy with the mannequin. Oh, I've got his number. He's one of them object sexuals.
What?
I'll have to take your word for that.
It's a term applied to individuals who fall in love with inanimate objects. Come on, you've heard of it. A type of paraphilia. It's like Dr. Johnson always says.
Oh my god.
Love has no boundaries.
United States Marshal.
What about the guy with the scar on his forehead? Stony face? In business class?
Oh yes. Workaholic. Textbook. He's got it bad too. He's either using his work to run away from something, or work itself is his reason for living.
Reason for living.
It's like Dr. Johnson always says.
Oh my god.
It doesn't matter what it is, just find a reason to live.
Okay, I'm done with you. Move this out of the way, I guess.
Front is a cherry blossom pattern.
Oh.
Snow is on the back.
So we are in some sort of different reality.
When did that change over?
Something, yeah. Oh, we got a piece of evidence. Nice. Hey, there's something going on over here.
It's a domestic flight. No large bags.
This is a different plane than the one that left. Well, I mean, I'm on a different plane than the one I was just on. I really don't like you. Stay away from me. Okay, these guys, yeah. Alright, tray table, anything?
There's nothing here.
Ew. Yeah, just close that up. What I would really like to get my hands on is that ticket. Hold on, I should look at the magazine. Just even though I'm not going to read it, I have a feeling I know what this is going to say to me. Yeah. It's a different... Yeah. Alright. It's a different hockey event. So things are different. Let's see. Can I eat your peanuts that hurt your feet? Is that cool? One of these had a ticket in it, and I'm wondering if it does... Ooh.
There's nothing here.
It's all scratched up. Pretty good at collecting scrapbook objects. I guess it's kind of neat because they're all magazines, so it's not that hard. There's another one right there, but I can like juke left and right. All right. Everybody, I really don't want to talk to this guy. I really don't want to. Oh man, I don't know why this guy creeps me out so bad.
When did you move to this seat?
He had a different color handkerchief before, didn't he?
When indeed.
Whoa.
Young Mr. Young. So funny you would ask.
What does that mean?
If time changes, so too does place. Time is of the essence. You, of all people, should understand.
Maybe I misread him. He's still really creepy, but...
Cutlery has to be stainless. Don't you agree?
Sure, man.
That lightning strike. How did you know about it before it even happened? Don't tell me you can control lightning strikes.
Your ability to look is not bad, but you need to be able to observe a little more carefully.
Truer words have never been spoken. The engine is perfect. Huh.
What did you observe?
The engine isn't damaged.
You have good observational skills.
Thank you.
You already know the answer. Am I correct?
Do you know what happened to the courier?
It might be said that I do, and it might be said that I don't.
You're a very irritating man.
Time changes, so too does place. Time is of the essence. Either way, Mr. Young, you cannot ask me to do your job for you.
Where's Olivia then?
What about that female member of the cabin crew?
You mean Olivia Jones? You saw her. Did she remind you of little Peggy?
Dude, extra cases? What? Hold on. Little Peggy first.
What do you know about little Peggy?
Blonde, blue eyes, and a mole by her eye. Did she smell of the same soap, too?
This is...
Just how much do you know?
This is uncomfortable.
Everything. You told me all of it yourself, Mr. Young. You're overlaying your memories of little Peggy onto Olivia, aren't you?
God, this guy talks so slowly, it's very frustrating.
Just, who are you?
It was a snowy night. I remember it very well. Is Amanda doing okay?
Amanda? What does she have to do with this?
Amanda? You know her too?
Her well-being is a good thing. A good indication of your own well-being, Mr. Young.
Okay, what about the clover? I don't...
What's going on here? What have you done to me?
Can you finally see them? These are things with a special meaning for you.
What are you talking about?
Catch them if you can. You may discover something. something about her.
Okay. So you have to catch clovers?
Clover represent your memories of her. Don't let them slip away.
For someone who is convinced that time is of the essence... what the? Okay. What are we... What? What is happening here? We're supposed to catch 100 clovers? Okay. Okay, so the red things indicate where lightning bolts are gonna come, so I can avoid them with my hand. That's great. And the clovers, that's easy. What the hell is going on? Oh, watch out. All right. I almost got myself in trouble there. Guys, no. Oh, shoot. Oh, okay. Okay, they don't kill you. There, we got 100. Oh, that was unduly stressful.
Have you remembered something?
What are you talking about?
Mr. Young.
Please speed it up. Okay, so maybe that's how we find pieces of the Peggy case, is by finding unrelated details and playing minigames with giants? No idea, man. No idea.
What's he talking about? Leaving something in my house, a memory with her. Clover, little Peggy? Could it be?
Alright, so that's super weird. I'm done. Wait, I can push this thing. Push that. Complete one extra case from Roland Walks. So wait, it smells like mold. Hold on.
The cherry blossoms and snow are switched.
Yep.
No mistake. So what does that mean?
I know that that's definitely... I need to sit back down and activate the tray table, please. Oh, this one doesn't let you. All right. Okay. Sure. All right, let's go poke this guy and see if he's super mean. Does he remember me? He probably doesn't.
It's like I'm not even here.
Oh dear. Control will be an issue if I can't find it. Sir. Can I help you with anything?
Where's Olivia?
Excuse me, sir. Exactly which Miss Olivia are you searching for?
Olivia Jones. She's a member of the crew, just like you are.
I'm very sorry, sir, but she isn't aboard this flight.
Come on. Did that lightning strike you too? She was right here a moment ago. In any case, you need to contact Logan Airport immediately. Tell them we have an emergency up here. Also, get the BPD to send some cops to the airport. Detective Forrest Kazin in particular. Give him my name and you'll have no problems.
Well, excuse me, sir. Are you hoping to use this confusion for something nefarious? If so, I'll have to stop you.
Next time, I'll break more than your watch.
Glove only on one hand. What for?
My most humble apologies, Mr. David Young. This incident has us all a little riled up, I'm sure.
Huh?
I'll make the call about the suspicious person immediately. To our destination, Ronald Reagan International Airport. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to get back to work.
Okay, so that's bizarre. I got a clue. So we're headed somewhere. To an airport. There's four pieces of evidence. Is that dude looking at me? Stop looking at me like that, bro. Freaking me out. Turn the water off. Shouldn't be wasting water. On an airliner, you actually have to, like, bring it. Okay. Always dirty, no matter what. Alright, so is there anything else in here? I can push the mirror. I can grab the mirror, look at myself. Who is...
Where'd the courier go to?
I'm having a moment here. Alright, there's another hockey magazine. Alright, let's get out of the lavatory, please. And we're gonna need to head back up the plane to Kitty Cat and see if we can find something. Yeah, let's look out. Okay, so everything's cool out there. That's fine.
The door looks fine.
I want to look at the airplane. Yeah, there. All right. Mini pretzels. There was the megaphone I used to beat up that other dude. I'm not... Does this door look fine? Do you know what you should not do? Oh, it's got scorch marks from the lightning? Okay, that's a nice little bit of clue. This is such a bad plan. Why are you doing this?
It won't open.
That's for the best.
There's more than 5 tons of pressure per square meter on that door. What was I thinking?
I was thinking it would earn me 10 credits. Dude, oh, it's actually showing me where food is. That's cool. Hey, there's some food right there. Hold on. I'll eat some potato chips and hang out. Alright, what is right there? It's like right... Oh, it's like... There. Nice. 1,000 extra credits. I guess we head up to business class and see if we can catch any more evidence there. That door is... This airline is the least safe ever. All of the exits are blocked, not just one of them. Everybody's freaking out. Hey, kitty. I'm actually going to talk to you. Kitty, kitty. Amanda, hook me up with some stamina, would you? 30, so I need, like... Another 50 or another 60. Yeah, let's do another 60. Let's eat two hamburgers. Back-to-back hamburgers. Don't feel bad, David. I've had days where I eat back-to-back hamburgers. I often try not to, but it does happen sometimes. All right. Yep, you have a nice nap, kitty. All right, let's go into business class. All right, let's try really hard not to antagonize the Sky Marshal this time. Hey, who's... Wife and daughter.
Marshal, are you okay? What's with the attitude? I'm only asking because I was worried. You'd think nothing happened at all.
I don't need your jabber, boy.
Real blood. He's working on the same drug case that we are, kind of.
I'm not sure why. But he seems determined to ignore me.
let's ask him about his daughter, because he'll love that.
About your daughter. Does she look like you? If she does, well, that's gotta be one unhappy kid.
Jeez, you're
voted
a jerk.
Most likely to be carved from stone. No prom date for her. Just having you as a father is enough to scare the boys off, I bet. But that's a surprise. You're the last person I'd expect to be carrying a picture of your family.
Yeah, you deserve that, man.
Listen up. I don't know who you are. But if you want to keep sucking down air, never talk to me again.
Well, that is very clear. Very clear why he really didn't want to talk to us last time.
My daughter does not need the likes of you worrying about her. She looks like her mother. Thank you very much.
Marshall Buchanan doesn't know who I am? There's something very odd going on here. But just what is it?
Can I talk to you, please?
I'll be slapped with a match penalty if I push my luck any further.
Stop using sports references. They're very, very stupid. Alright. Dude, I totally want this foam finger. That's cool. Yeah. Okay.
Nothing says Boston quite like this.
Big number one finger.
Must be a baseball fan on board.
Well, that's kind of cool. And kind of a cute little mini game. There we go.
It's for Boston versus New York. Pretty good seats, too. Of course, it's been used. Things don't come that easy.
Well, that's okay. What I'm looking for is that same... Yeah, the ticket that we did that with earlier. Oh, that's a clue? All right. So you've got all of the Boston versus DC evidence. We're going the other way. Hey, it's our guy. Our fashion designer friend here. Milan Fall and Winter Collection of 2013. The Milan Collection is one of the five collections held in Milan, Italy, at the end of February every year. This season saw the unveiling of many appealing new sensational items. In particular, retro and military fashion of the individualist designer Duncan matches seamlessly with current trends as a major presence during the show. Retro and military fashion unveiled him the season of kitsch is not... and yet eye-catching. A solid base of his existing paradigms, while dynamically fusing them with a modern approach, is likely to why this is evaluated so highly. So he's not doing avant-garde fashion at the moment. He's doing stuff that's in, like, stuff that's in vogue on purpose. In fact, he probably won't even... He's look at his crazy stuff. Mesh tape top, nipple showing, shaved pits, unbelievable. Let's talk to you, buddy.
Oh, ma chérie, I know. You must have been so scared. How is my Suki? Okay. There'll be champagne as soon as we arrive in DC. Ooh, I think some Chardonnay might be nice.
Didn't your mannequin just break?
Hey, excuse me. She's Suki, not a mannequin. Therefore, she most certainly cannot ever just break. Do you intend to make an enemy of the entire fashion industry?
No, that mannequin got totally wrecked.
Tut tut! Say another word, mister, and I shall unleash
matching scarves, matching makeup,
anger.
Matching hairdos.
Okay, you win. Forget I even asked about you, mannequin. My bad. No more about Suki.
That's right. She's not a mannequin. We can forget this ever happened. Of course, us being top fashion designers, we're never going to remember you anyway. Your choices in fashion, so terrible. How can one walk outside wearing that?
I should really not press that anymore.
When did you become a military maniac?
This is fashion, you heathen. Retro and military, it's called. Both Suki and I are completely anti-war, of course.
Okay. But what I really wanted to know was, when did you change your clothes?
Progress cannot be stopped. When we changed is not what is important. Rather, the question should be, when can we change? Indeed, just look. The fashion we have on right now is already headed toward obscurity. It's imminent, like fluttering petals. At any moment, new inspiration is going to just explode into my brain. Like, of and avant.
Avant-garde! Eureka!
Yeah, that's all you, man. You can have that.
Just lifted the fog from my brain in a flash. Now, say it with me. Avant-garde. This will be my next theme.
Okay, so this is... That's good. Two pieces remaining. This might still provide me with evidence.
Your mannequin...
I mean Suki. Come on.
Is Suki really okay?
You're so persistent. Look at her smooth, perfect body. She doesn't have a mark on her.
I am gonna look at Suki. Why not?
Oh, you're so good. Oh, my Suki. Please stop staring like that. You're scaring poor Suki. She really hates beardy, scruffy animals like you most of all.
Well, fair enough. Do you have another one?
Can I ask you something? How many spare Sukis do you have?
Hey! There's no spare for her! She's unique in all the world! And one of a kind to me.
Okay, so that's the only Okay, so we did that. Oh, here we go. Unbelievably smooth.
You are just too lovely.
He's super weirdly into her.
You, I doubt I could go on living.
This does look like the real Suki.
She was really smooth.
Just what's going on here?
What is this game, guys? What is this game? Alright, so we did the cutting edge of fashion one. What do we got left? One piece of evidence remains. A red color powder. Dude, this dude's been using.
You've got red powder on your clothes. What is it?
Achoo! Oh, excuse me.
Yeah, dude, you're a real blood user too,
exactly,
man.
What exactly is this red powder on my clothing? I don't see anything at all.
An elite fashion designer and a mysterious powder? My instincts as a former narcotics detective tell me something's up. I'll question him and find out more.
Alright, what I think I'm gonna do here is I'm actually gonna end this episode and we'll just start up a new one. It's been fun, guys. I hope to see you soon. We will question the fashion designer on his drug choices in just a minute.